Talk Radio 640 WGST. Welcome to Health Tech Talk. This is where business, healthcare, and technology collide. Our host, Ben Chodor, interviews healthcare innovators and industry titans who are striving to make the world healthier with bleeding-edge human ingenuity. You'll hear it all on Health Tech Talk. Now, here's your host, Ben Chodor.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. You're listening to Health Tech Talk, broadcasting live from 640 WGST, from the iHeartRadio studios, and streaming worldwide on the iHeartRadio network. All right, we have an incredible show today. I have three amazing guests, and we're going to get to them in a couple seconds. But I want to remind the audience that every one of our shows is available on demand on iTunes, YouTube, Vimeo, and at the HealthTechTalk.com website, and as well as on iHeartRadio, which you're listening to right now. So we're actually now syndicating everywhere. It's really exciting. We've had incredible response about the show. And I want to jump right into my first guest. All right. So it's a really cool company, DrChrono. My first guest is their COO and co-founder, Daniel Kivatinos. Has an incredible background. Right? He has been in the technology space since 2001 as a software engineer and entrepreneur. He holds an MS in computer science and a BS in computer science and psychology from Stony Brook University. His company, DrChrono, creates the best EHR, just for our audience doesn't know, that's electronic health records experience for physicians and their patients. They seamlessly integrate also into iPad, iPhone, and yes, let my audience know, also into the Apple Watch. Another cool fact about the company, there's over 70,000 physicians and 4 million patients to date have touched their technology. I think that's an amazing number. These guys are changing the way physicians and patients and their records integrate. And I think it's incredible. So with no further ado, Daniel, welcome to the show. How are you today?
I'm doing well, Ben.
Great. I want you to jump in. Paint a picture to my audience so they just understand before we jump into some deep questions. What is the mission statement of DrChrono, and how do both physicians and patients touch it?
Sure. So DrChrono is a mobile medical records platform for physicians and for patients. So if you think about everyone in the United States and in the world, we're moving towards a mobile sort of space. You have social networking on your mobile phones. You have your banking on your mobile phones. You have your email on your mobile phone. You have all these different things on your mobile phone, pictures of your family. And whenever I talk to people, most people don't have their medical records on their phone. So what we're trying to do is enable physicians and patients to have this sort of technology at their fingertips when they need it, which is extremely important in the world where we're sort of traveling. People are taking planes all over the place. You know, people go skiing. They need to travel. Whatever, wherever they are, they want to get access to their medical records. They want access to their family's medical records. I mean, when you look at the industry as it is today, it's sort of a lagger behind other industries like social networking. If you look at companies like Facebook, they've connected people with their families from around the world. Now, we need to move healthcare in that same genre where we're connecting families with their medical records through their phones. So you could pull up your son's medical record or your grandparents' medical record and just say to a physician, this is the drugs that they're on. This is their blood work. This is the last time they've gone to their doctor. Here's some shots. So it sort of gives it'll enable patients to realize what had happened to them in the past, who they had seen in the past, who their family members have seen in the past. And if you look at the way where we're moving as an industry, there's this whole movement towards the Internet of Things.
Yep.
And what that means is there are all these devices that are coming out that sort of connect into the phone and the tablet phone where you can pull in this data. So if you look at blood pressure cuffs,
right,
they actually have blood pressure cuffs that are FDA approved where you can pull this data into your phone and share that with your doctor. And that's what we're doing at DrChrono. You know, you have glucose meters. You can pull this data in. So say you have a family member who has diabetes. You could actually, as a family member, look at their blood readings and say, hey, you know, your blood is a little high. Let me contact the physician and let them know what we should do about this. So all of these devices are coming out that sort of bring it together with the phone, and then the doctor can also see this data. So I wouldn't be surprised. Yep.
So I just want to ask a question. So right now I see three major uses, right? One is I'm traveling, I'm in another state, another country, and I get sick. And now instantly the doctor I see, if I bring up my patient information, they know what I'm allergic to, they know what I've had in the past. That's incredible, right? Two is, hey, if I have a mother, you know, or a father in another state who has something, I could be monitoring their patient information too. But also with my current doctor, if I'm uploading this information, I'm always staying engaged with my physician, even when I'm not with them. Do I sort of get the overall picture?
And that's exactly right. I think that's sort of where it's going. Like for me, I'll tell you one example for myself. I called a physician on a Saturday, and the physician honestly didn't remember who I was.
Right.
He didn't have this one physician didn't have a picture of his patients when they called. So he would pull up, you know, he wasn't able to access the medical record outside of his office. He didn't have a picture of the patient or anything like that. And, you know, I was calling him on a Saturday asking him questions, and he was trying to recall this from memory. And healthcare shouldn't be like that. It should be more of, if the doctor's in their car and they want to talk to a patient, they should have a picture of that patient. They'd be able to, you know, pick up, look at x-rays and those sorts of things. So the way that healthcare is today, it's not where it should be, right? Mm-hmm. So when you're traveling or when you're going room to room even,
yeah,
doctors sometimes have these things. They're called a COW, a computer on wheels, in hospitals. And they have to drag this large device from room to room. And they don't want to do that. They're seeing patients really at a rapid pace, and they want the data, and they want it now. And you want it as a patient also. You want to walk out of the doctor's office mm-hmm. and say, What is that patient material that he just gave me? You know, sometimes they'll give you a pamphlet and you'll lose it. Sometimes they'll give you a prescription for a drug and you'll lose it. And sort of enabling patients to have this all digital on their phone allows you not to lose that data, and also to message back and forth with your doctor. It allows them to engage with their own staff when they're not in the actual hospital. It makes total sense to everyone when we talk about it. And I think we have to bring that as a country, as the United States, towards that new age where things are going. And I think it's going to happen no matter what. It's a matter of who's going to do it.
How has the adoption been going so far? I mean, your numbers seem pretty amazing to me, but how's the adoption?
It's been, we've been having huge growth over the last several years simply because people are buying iPads and iPhones and tablet devices, and they want that information on their phone. And if you look at some of the larger, older vendors, they're really running on the older tech stacks. So what they'll do is they'll go into a hospital, they'll install, you know, multiple million dollars worth of hardware and software. And when the doctor walks out of the hospital, they can't get that data. And the patient can't get that data. So
DrChrono makes it possible for everyone, not only the physician to get my information, the patient to have the information, and any other third party that I need to share it with.
That's exactly right. Yeah. And we're trying to minimize any mistakes. So, like, it sounds sort of ridiculous, but you don't get a picture of the patient on the medical record in a lot of the software that exists today.
And DrChrono.
And, you know, you could be making a mistake. Like, right? You walk in as a physician, you're seeing 30 patients, you walk into the wrong room, and you start prescribing drugs, and you're looking at a medical record, and you're saying something that doesn't relate to
Daniel,
that
I got to interrupt you because the segment is over. This is incredible. You've been listening to DrChrono. This is Health Tech Talk. We'll be back after these.